Hello, everybody. It's Sunday night. The name of the show is Intuitive Inc., and I am Servette Hassan. We do have another great show for you tonight. My guest tonight is Mark Alyn, who I know quite well. He's an award-winning host and producer. And during his 20 plus, and maybe we need to put another plus in there, 20 plus plus years, he's been a television host, a reporter, a producer. He's hosted a reality show, a live game show, a movie trivia program, and I predict in the future another game show. Who knows? Anyway, he also is the host of Late Night Health on KABC Radio, which I believe is all his mother's fault, but we'll talk about that. He's become what I consider a truly devoted healthcare consumer advocate, and I'm delighted to have you here on a Sunday night away from your family and friends, assuming you have any friends. But we're so happy to have you, Mark.
You're
welcome.
My only friend.
I knew that was coming. I just knew you were going to say that. Hello, Mark. How are you?
Servette, so nice to be with you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I teased a little there about how this was your mother's fault being the host of Late Night Health radio show. But I think it truly was. Isn't that kind of how it started? That she wanted you to be a doctor and you never ended up being a doctor?
Hmm? Well, everybody's mom at that time when I was growing up in the L.A. area, everybody's wanted to be a doctor. Everybody, at least a lot of my friends did.
Right.
And my mom, you know, kind of encouraged me. But I got to tell you, I got smacked upside the head with math so fast it'd make your head spin. So it just was not meant to be. And what really decided for me, and I explained to my mom, we had a lab practical. Do you remember doing that?
Oh,
did you ever have to do one of those?
Oh, yes.
So for extra credit, I helped this, and this is a totally different life. I mean, I was 16 years old, and we had to do a lab practical and look inside the cavity of a frog, and it would be marked. It had A, and another part would be B and C, and you had to be able to tell the difference between a pancreas and a kidney and a lung and a heart and all that. I couldn't get it straight if my life depended on it.
Well, there you go. Was not meant to be.
It was not meant to be.
Yeah. I don't like blood. So there you go. It just does not work. And I have two brothers who are doctors. One of my youngest brother is a surgeon and my oldest brother is an internist. So I know what it's like. I mean, I've seen them go through the whole thing and they love it. I mean, truly love it. But I'm just not built for that. Blood and I pass out.
I can go into surgery now as a video producer. Oh. I have no problem with that. And kind of direct some video. I a couple of years ago, I went in and watched a surgeon do some work. I've done it a couple of times. My family thought I'd pass out. They took bets.
Right.
And I won. I didn't pass out.
Well, that's a good thing. That's a really good thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you can watch it. You just can't do it. Is that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. That makes sense. It's got to be hard. I mean, I could see, and you see, this is your real talent. Your real gift is being a producer and a host. So, I mean, of whatever it may be. So I could see you doing that. I could see you going in there and just getting the camera right into the nitty gritty. But that's a different thing than you being in it, you know?
Yeah, I don't want to, you know, I don't want to kill bugs or spiders. And I certainly don't want to take the responsibility of killing a person.
Right. I get it.
Right.
Yeah, no, that's a good thing. Yeah, yeah, I understand that totally. Well, how did Late Night Health come about? How did that start?
Well, I've been a broadcaster for a long time, maybe 20 plus years. I don't know. Uh-huh. And my back went out one night. I woke up and my back hurt. I was walking at a 90-degree angle, and I could not for the life of me figure out why. But I hobbled to the shower, steamed my back, went to my chiropractor, and I was fine. 3 days later, it was back. Woke up in pain. My, you know, couldn't walk because, I mean, I could walk, but I was hobbling. Anyway, after the third or fourth or fifth time, my wife insisted that I see a doctor, a rheumatologist. Mm-hmm. And I didn't want to go because I'd always had an alternative health bent. And I was frankly a little bit afraid he might find something that needed surgery or might need a lot of heavy drugs. Anyway, I went to the guy and he examined me and gave me three offers, if you will, to help my back. The first was drugs. And he said, now, if you have drugs, understand you're not going to be able to work or drive. I said, well, I have to work and I have to drive. He goes, okay, so drugs are off the table. Mm. He said, I can give you a shot. It'll make you feel better, but it won't make the condition better. He said, the problem with that is you'll be overconfident and you may further injure your back. Mm. And I said, well, that's off the table. And the third thing he said was physical therapy. So I took PT. And he made me promise that I would go 3 times a week for 3 months. And that's what the prescription said. After 5 visits, I got a call or a letter from the insurance company based here in Southern California. And they're in many states, Anthem Blue Cross, because they're the little black-hearted bastards. Oh, I'm sorry. This is a family show.
That's all right.
And they canceled the physical therapy.
Huh.
And I started complaining. And about that time, a friend of mine, the insane Daryl Wayne of K-Rock fame, called me up and said, hey, what would you do if you'd go back on the radio? I'd been off for about a year concentrating on my video production and marketing business. And I said, and this came from source, Servette, mm-hmm. because I had a feeling Daryl was going to ask me that, and I was thinking, I want to do a restaurant and travel show. That would be fun again. And out of my mouth, the following words popped out. I want to do a show that empowers people 40 plus to take charge of their health care and to be empowered to do so. Mm-hmm. And he looked at me. And I continued by saying it would be a blend of alternative and allopathic or traditional Western medicine. That's what I want to do. Hmm. And he said, great. And that's how we started.
Wow. Okay. So how did you put this together? First of all, what happened with the insurance company, with your back, with the physical therapy?
My back still occasionally does go out. It's been 6 years. I don't take PT. I take physiotherapy from my chiropractor, and Anthem pays for that. They're just, you know, we're going to talk about this. Our healthcare system is broken. My job, I think, one of my passions has become to help people learn about the various aspects of healthcare and that they are in charge, not their doctors.
Right. Wow. Okay. So that, yeah. So the end of the story is, do you still have back trouble?
Yes. Well, not like I did. Mm-hmm. I go to a chiropractor every now and then when it's acting up. Mm-hmm. And that's it. But really, I don't have any problems.
Is that from the physical therapy and then just continuing to do that at home and keeping up with that?
No, it just kind of cured itself.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So are you a big believer in chiropractors?
Yes.
Okay. Because a lot of people aren't, and some are covered, some are not. It just so it depends on the insurance company too, right? I mean, it's not.
Yeah, it does, and chiropractic. It's interesting. Some of the first of all, chiropractic is to me the first step to healthcare. All chiropractors have more instruction and education in the body, in nutrition. They understand supplements. There's so many differences in the education of a chiropractor versus a traditional MD, mm-hmm. medical doctor. Mm-hmm. But they are both doctors. It's still 6 years of schooling. You've got 4 years of, I don't even know how, and each state is different, but in California, you have to have a bachelor's degree, then you go in for a three or four year course, and then there's extra study, and there's continuing education. And I believe chiropractic should be the first line of defense in treating illness, because they go about looking for the source of the problem, mm-hmm. not simply treating the symptoms, which many doctors do, MDs do.
Well, yes, and MDs are so, most MDs, again, it depends on the chiropractor, it depends on the MD, but most MDs are so stressed with like 5 minutes per patient, you know? They're not looking for the source. They're just looking to make you feel better.
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree.
And I think it's terrible. As I said earlier, the system is broken, mm-hmm. and we need to fix it. Time Magazine a few years ago did a 2-year investigative report, and they picked a hospital in Texas, and the reporter found out that generic Tylenol, mm-hmm. Acetaminophen,
right.
would be prescribed and charged, I don't know, $3 or $4 per pill. And their reason was because they would have to cover people who help people who don't have insurance. And that's still, to me, that's just bogus. It's just a way of making money.
That doesn't make any sense, actually. Yeah.
No. They use it to cover their losses. So if you have insurance, mm-hmm. you're going to pay $4. Your insurance company has to pay $4 a pill for generic Tylenol. So if you're in the hospital, and you need generic Tylenol, for $2 you can buy, X number of pills at CVS.
Right.
Well, why not do that? It doesn't make sense. It doesn't compute in my head.
No, it doesn't compute. And I remember after surgery, I got acetaminophen in the hospital, and that prescription ran out really quickly. And I thought, oh, do I need another prescription? And I thought, well, of course not. You just go to CVS, buy it, and take an extra pill. And then that's the same strength as the prescription. So that didn't make any sense to me at all.
It doesn't. There's a lot of things that don't make sense. Why would a doctor prescribe a big pharma drug knowing that there are a lot of side effects, mm-hmm. versus prescribing supplements that have been shown to work, mm-hmm. that have no known side effects, mm-hmm. that have been studied, and yet they don't use those?
Well,
doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah. So do you encourage everyone out there to first try the holistic naturopathic medicine before the traditional?
Yeah, obviously there's a need for, I go to an MD. Mm-hmm. I have a great doc, and I do go to it.
Right.
And there's, for emergency surgery, you mm-hmm. don't want to go to a massage therapist.
Exactly.
I mean, you know, if you're in a car accident, mm-hmm. you need to, you know, you can't go to a holistic healer, in my opinion, go to a holistic healer and get an herbal tea for pain.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? It's not going to work.
Right.
It's just not. You need something strong. Mm-hmm. And in this particular case, you need to see the difference and to weigh the price and the cost and the time,
mm-hmm.
and see what your situation is. I mean, if you're sleepless or you have restless leg syndrome or whatever it might be,
mm-hmm.
you have to make a choice yourself. Because it's your body. It's not the doctors. It's not your health care providers. It's yours.
Right. It's not the insurance companies. Right. And they're going to do
right.
whatever they can to keep their your costs down for them. I mean, they're not.
Well, that I think is a misnomer. I don't understand the way they do it. I'll give you an example. A few years ago,
mm-hmm.
I mean, what you're saying is true. They don't want to pay for things. And they deny, deny, deny.
Right.
Blue Cross actually has a company here in California. I would assume that throughout the country where late night health is, either on the internet or in Lake Tahoe or in Albuquerque, that it's the same, that insurance companies have hired third-party companies to deny claims. So you have a non-trained clerk
mm-hmm.
who is trained, and they have a stack of people saying, I need to go to an orthopedic surgeon, or I need physical therapy.
Mm-hmm.
Well, physical therapy is really easy for them to deny.
Mm-hmm.
And so they have this clerk, they go through it, they deny the claim, it's looked at by a physical therapist, and the claim is denied. Eyeglasses are another example.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I went, got a pair of eyeglasses a few years ago. The bill was $700. And I said to the optometrist, I said, that's ridiculous. And she said, oh, no, Mark, you're not going to pay $700. I said, oh, I'm not? No, of course not. You're only going to pay $300.
Oh, cool.
I said, so I give you $300. I said, I have a benefit of $300 from the insurance company for my glasses. So you get $600 out of this. Yeah. I said, I can go to Costco
right.
and get a pair of glasses for $250. But my glasses are better than Costco glasses. I went
right.
to Costco.
You did go to Costco.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Well, yeah. I mean, that's where I go. That's where my glasses are from. I have
actually my latest glasses are from China because, again, it's what they do is they mark up the bill so high, and doctors do it, optometrists do it. They mark it up, and the insurance companies know they're doing this, and there's some kind of formula, and they get they get 60% of what they bill, but they're still getting what they really want.
Right. And then, again, like you said, they're denying. Like, if you want to go to an acupuncturist or a chiropractor, I'm with my insurance company, that's just going to get denied no matter what. Right? Hello? Hello? Oh, my goodness. I think we have lost Mark. Here he comes back again. Hello. Hello, Mark.
Hi. That was my fault. I hit the wrong button.
Okay. Well, don't worry about that. We're live, and these things happen. You will not believe the kinds of things that happen when you do a live show, except you probably would, Mark, because you are an award-winning host and producer. So I'm sure you've seen.
I have done, yes.
Yeah, you've seen a lot. And you know things just happen. So, I mean, I had one interview where she just had the hiccups and they were not going to stop. And, you know what? You just do the best you can do, and you just keep going. So, yeah,
right.
I get it. So
right.
My question was, if you want to go to an acupuncturist or a chiropractor, I know my insurance company is going to deny it. Is there anything you can do about that?
I know that my insurance company, which is still, believe it or not, Anthem Blue Cross, covers chiropractic. I don't believe they cover acupuncture or acupressure.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you could go to a chiropractor who also is an acupuncturist. I know one in Los Angeles, for example.
Mm-hmm.
And he could code the request so that you could, the insurance company will pick it, it will pay for it because it's a chiropractic treatment. That's a little gray area, and I'm not suggesting that people lie to the insurance companies.
No,
but there's got to be a change. There's
right.
There's the insurance companies are taking advantage, took advantage of Obamacare.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to whatever happens with health care under the current reign. It's going to happen to the advantage of the insurance companies. I mean, these, you know, heads of insurance companies get bonuses of millions of dollars a year. And those bonuses come from the denying of medical care. In fact, doctors no longer make decisions.
Really?
No, the insurance companies do.
Hmm.
So somebody comes in and says, I don't feel well. And the doctor says, well, I'm going to run this test for you.
Mm-hmm.
And they find out that test, while covered, they deny it and they want another test done because they can't. Because they can say, well, we want you to use this test. And the doctor says, well, I don't like that test. It's not accurate. It's tough.
So what are we doing about this? Anything? Seriously, is there anything
we're listening to late night health radio.
There you go.
And learning about different things that you can do mm-hmm. to take charge of your health care and get it out of the hands of Big Pharma and the insurance companies.
Right. Right. And yeah. And then, like you said, if you want holistic naturopathic medicine, you can if you just fight for it, I suppose. And then also you need to know that they're good too. You have to find good doctors just like you do with a regular MD.
There's no question.
Mm-hmm.
There's no question that I mean, there are good doctors
mm-hmm.
that understand and give you more than 5 or 7 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
There are doctors who don't listen. I'll give you one. I know somebody who said to her doctor, I researched this on the internet, and I'd like to tell you what it said. And the doctor said, why? You're a doctor now with a medical degree from the internet?
Yeah.
I've got a degree from a real school.
Mm-hmm.
I would have fired the guy's ass.
Yeah, find another doctor. Find another doctor. Yeah.
Yeah.
I would.
He wasn't paying attention. He wasn't. He didn't care what the patient said. He was the only. He was in charge. Unfortunately, for older people,
mm-hmm.
say 50 plus, maybe 60 plus, doctors, we've been taught, we've learned that doctors are the answer, and this is wrong. What do you call your doctor, Servant? Your primary care physician.
What do I call him? What do you mean? Like,
yeah. What's his name? I mean, do you call him Dr. Smith? Or
no,
or
I call him I call him Dr. Pandy. His last name is
okay.
Pandy. It's, yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. Next time you go in, you call him by his first name. And the reason is, if you don't, you're not on the same level playing field. I've been told, well, that's disrespectful to him. Mm-hmm. When a doctor comes in on a first appointment, mm-hmm. walks in, says, I'm Dr. Nandy, I'm Dr. Smith, I'm Dr. Pandy, whatever his name is, mm-hmm. and says, hi, Mark, I'm Dr. Smith. Mm-hmm. Right there, he's put himself in charge of your health care and you. Mm-hmm. And that's not acceptable to me.
Well, that's an interesting point. Very interesting. And it's funny because my surgeon that cut me in half, I call her Leslie. I do. I mean, I really feel like, you know, when I have my first follow-up appointment with her, she gave me a hug and I said, thank you, Leslie. I didn't say Dr.
Absolutely.
Randall. Yeah, I didn't say Dr. That just came out. I didn't even think about that. But it is kind of true that you're not on the same. And also, they've never called me Miss Hassan either, or Ms. Hassan. They've just...
No, of course, they don't. They call you by your first name. They said, okay, Servette, here's what's going on.
Right, exactly.
And that's a lack of respect.
Hmm. It's interesting. And I do, I find that if a doctor's not listening to me, I'm done. Because I've talked before. I mean, this happened to me 100 years ago when I was married, and he's been gone for over 23 years now. But the doctor I went to with him, he just went with me to be nice. There was no reason for him to come. He just thought he'd come hold my hand. And the doctor only talked to him about me. And then finally,
yep.
I just said to him, I said, Doc, I'm over here. I'm here. They were talking about me like I wasn't there. And I said, that's not acceptable, and I'm not coming. I never saw that doctor again.
Well, and you shouldn't.
No.
The thing is that it's okay to bring somebody to be an advocate, one, especially
right.
if you're older.
Mm-hmm.
And if you suspect that there's going to be a terrible diagnosis, such as in your case with cancer,
right?
It's good to have somebody there with you because you're going to be in shock.
Right, and you forget what they say.
You're going to forget everything they say, mm-hmm. except that you have cancer, and in your head you're going to say, oh, nuts, I'm dying.
Mm-hmm. Right, you do. You go there really quick.
So you do.
So, and you don't hear. In fact, every appointment I had after that, I always had someone there with me taking notes. And
good.
Fortunately, because my younger brother is a surgeon, my surgeon allowed me to have him on the phone, on speakerphone, for every appointment I had up until the surgery. So he was listening, and then it was surgeon to surgeon, even though he's a retina surgeon, and she's obviously a gynecological surgeon, but... He still knew the right questions to ask that I wouldn't know to ask.
Right.
So that was lovely. And not everyone can have that, but at least someone was there. Cause I would leave going, huh? Who, what? Cause.
Right.
Yeah. I couldn't remember half of anything she said. I was still, my head was reeling, you know, it's like you're in shock, like you said. So it is good to have somebody else there, but they should be talking to you and they should be listening to you. That's the key to me too, is they should be listening and
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, not a lot of doctors do that. They're not listening. But I am going to interrupt you for a second now because we are halfway through the show. So I'm opening the lines for anyone to call in with any questions for Mark Alyn, who is the host of Late Night Health on KABC Radio and has become a devoted healthcare consumer advocate and knows all these, has interviewed hundreds and hundreds of people regarding these questions about health insurance and the system and everything else to do with that, including holistic naturopathic medicine along with the traditional type of medicine. So if anybody has any questions, now's the time to call Mark, 949-313-8880. Please call in now if you have anything to ask, and I'm sure he'll do his best to answer. Anyway, we are halfway through the show, so I just, at the same time, Mark, want to let people know how they can reach out to you and where they can find out when your show airs and everything else about you, and that is at latenighthealth.com, right?
That is correct.
Good. And they can also find you on Facebook, right?
Yep. Facebook.com/LateNightHealthRadio. And Twitter is easy. At Twitter. @LateNightHealth.
@LateNightHealth.
That's why it's
That. But it's on Twitter. No, you're not a twit. You're far from that. I love what you're doing and how you're trying to help people. And you are extremely knowledgeable. I know you've talked to so many doctors and so many healthcare professionals and everything else under the sun to try and fix this. So this is good. And if people listen to Late Night Health, they can find out what to do about not getting screwed over with the health insurance system, right?
Well, and we cover that. We cover a lot of things. I mean, our show is, changes week to week. And we talk to doctors and authors and other people. Understand, I'm just a consumer. I'm a healthcare consumer just like you. Mm-hmm. And I can't, if you call me up and say, hey, Mark, I've got a sore throat. All I can tell you is go to the urgent care. You might want to gargle with salt water. That's what my dad made me do. Mm-hmm. But I'm not a doctor. I'm not a healthcare professional.
Right.
I ask questions. That's what I do.
Right.
And I encourage other people listening to ask questions as well.
Right. Well, your show does cover a lot of different things. It even covers the spiritual side of things, too, because I know you have Robert Clancy on there quite often, who has that Facebook fan page, Guide to the Soul. So, that's interesting. That's part of it all, too. I think it's not just physical, it's mental, it's a lot of things, so.
Well, I think there's a spiritual aspect to health.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And without that spiritual aspect, I believe that you don't heal as quickly, you don't get as well as quickly. Mm-hmm. I think that it's, I think it's important to have a belief that there's something bigger than us. It doesn't matter if it's Jesus or Mohammed.
We have a caller calling in.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
No, I agree. I totally agree. Here we go. Hello, caller. Hello, caller. Hi, caller. Can you hear us?
Yes, I can. Thank you.
Oh, good. And what's your name?
Hi. Catherine,
and where are you calling from?
Phoenix, Arizona.
Wow, great. Thank you. Go ahead. Do you have a question for Mark?
Actually, Mark, I have two. I find the show very interesting. Two questions. You're most welcome. The first question is regarding Western medicine versus holistic or Eastern medicine. And do you think that it is okay if you're seeing medical doctors and if you don't get reprieve for them, you try the other ones? But do you see, can you use both at once or should you stick to one avenue or the other?
I can't. It's an individual choice. I can't advise because, again, I'm not a healthcare professional. I think there's a new arena and it's called integrative medicine, where a doctor an MD might do acupressure or acupuncture, might do Reiki energy healing, or refer you to somebody who does that. And so it becomes integrative, using the best part of Western medicine blended with Eastern or alternative health.
So you have to search for somebody that does that.
If you do a search on, on the internet for integrative health in your community, I'm sure you'll find somebody. Where are you calling again from? I'm sorry.
Arizona, Phoenix.
Arizona. I know, actually, if you do, there are doctors in Arizona who practice integrative health.
All right. And so it's up to the individual whether they choose to do so or not.
Okay.
Right.
And they have to decide if it's harmful or helpful, more or less.
Well, yeah. It's completely up to you. And that, by the way, is the foundation of late night health. I don't care if you choose to go to an allopathic doctor. If you make that conscious choice, or if you choose to go to some kind of alternative practitioner, the fact is that the choice is up to you, and it is totally an individual choice. I mean, some okay. people, mm-hmm. you know, it's just that simple.
Okay. Thank you very much. My second question is, I feel or believe that there are millions and billions of dollars being spent on lobbyists and insurance companies to get people to buy drugs because it's a moneymaker. Are there
yep.
any millions or billions of dollars of people that are lobbying for naturopathic health or vitamins and
yes.
supplements versus drugs?
Yes. There's the Natural Products Association. They are a lobbying group. They do not have millions or billions of dollars. They're very small. There's the Natural and Organic Association, also in Washington, D.C. Good friend of mine runs that, Karen Howard. And those are just two of the organizations that I can think of. There's botanical, I can't think of the name of it right now. There's another organization that studies herbs and botanicals, and they're based in Austin, Texas. So there are a number of them. What they do is they lobby the government to allow supplements to be used. I'll give you an example. You know, in the last few years, the Attorney General in New York City had certain supplements pulled off the shelves of every Walmart, vitamin shop, and I don't know who else, and said we've done testing, and these products don't contain what it says on the label. Well, the federal law says if it says it on the label, it must be in that capsule. And the Attorney General, who I think just resigned, they ran the wrong tests to see if that product was correct or not.
Wow.
It was stupid.
Huh.
So did somebody buy that off?
Well, they, I don't remember what the settlement was. The supplements, I believe, are now back on the shelves. The labeling is correct. The labeling was never wrong. And the ingredients have to be in the product. When somebody manufactures a supplement, Catherine,
yeah.
I find it interesting. The raw ingredients come in. They have to be tested by a third party. They're mixed into that capsule. They're tested by a third party. And just before they're bottled, they're tested again to make sure that it's clean, that everything that's on the label is in that capsule. Now, are there companies who don't do that? Absolutely. But it's the same kind of thing where big pharma companies don't follow the rules either. You know, it's individual people running it. I really appreciate your questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much, and I look forward to the rest of the show.
Thank you so much for calling in from Phoenix. Thank you so much. That was nice. If we have any other callers that need to have a question or two, Call in now, 949-313-8880. We're wrapping up here already, so we've just got a few more minutes for another call. If anyone dares to call in now, please do so. Those were good questions, weren't they, Mark?
Absolutely. They're right on, spot on, as they say.
Right. Now, when does Late Night Health run air on KABC Radio?
Well, on KABC in the Southern California area, it runs at 1 a.m. on Saturday morning. One of the reasons we're on so late is the audience is an older audience, and people, you know, 50 plus start having sleep problems. Radio is a companion.
Mm-hmm.
Radio is a friend. So if somebody is awake, and let's say their spouse has passed away,
mm-hmm.
or they're divorced. They've gone out. They had a dull date.
Mm-hmm.
They're alone. They want a friend. I'm trying to fill that void.
Oh, that's lovely.
And we're also incorporating the latest technology.
Mm-hmm.
So we're on iTunes, we're on SoundCloud, we're on other radio networks
right.
that are internet-based.
Right. So people can still hear the show regardless of when it aired.
They can pick it up later. Right.
Right. So
yeah.
You have a podcast, basically, which people can catch up to on iTunes.
Well, it's a radio. We call it a radio show, but yes, it has a podcasting element to it. They can go to iTunes. They can go to latenighthealth.com, latenighthealth.com, and if they go there, most of the shows are posted, and you can listen right there on your computer, or you can do it on any of your mobile devices, like an iPhone or an Android.
Right, I saw that. Like at least like 5 or 6 shows were up when I went onto your website that you've done recently.
I think we keep adding new shows every week.
Yeah, exactly. So they're there if you want to hear them, everybody. It's latenighthealth.com. And our guest tonight is Mark Alyn. And you're wonderful. I'm glad you're doing this because people need to know. And this is where people feel helpless when it comes to this because it's like they're just being told. And especially if they're older, they think there's nothing they can do about it. You know, if someone says that's not covered, they don't know that they have an alternative.
Well, there's a couple of alternatives for them. One alternative, mm-hmm. of course, is to fight the denial.
Mm-hmm.
They have a right to do that.
Right.
You know, do you remember the old joke? I know when I've seen you, I think I did this to you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a little old lady goes to the doctor and she takes her right arm, she bends the elbow
uh-huh.
and bends her elbow like she's doing a bicep exercise.
Right.
And she says, "Doc, it hurts when I do this."
Uh-huh.
So what does the doctor say? What's his answer or her answer?
Don't do it.
Right.
Don't do it. Yeah.
But that's the old answer.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Because most people, most older people go, "Oh, okay," and they stop doing that.
Right.
But that's not where it should end. Where it should end is, "Okay, doc, I'll stop doing it, but why does it hurt?"
Right.
Why?
Why?
People don't ask that follow-up question, and that's really important for them to do.
Hmm. Yeah, it is really important to why is it hurting, right? No, I get that.
Right.
I've just been put in physical therapy for some pain in my right lower quadrant in my abdomen. From the surgery, and you know, they literally tell me if the insurance has approved it or not while I'm sitting there in the doctor's office, and it came back. Go ahead.
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
I just said something
mm-hmm.
where I got paperwork that said you've been approved for payment by the insurance company.
Mm-hmm.
That's the good news. Then the next line says, however, we have the right, this is from Blue Cross, we have the right not to pay it, which means that you go in for some procedure, mm-hmm. some test, mm-hmm. and they have the right, which is just absolutely ridiculous, to say, no, we're not going to pay that now. I know some people who are going through something right now. Not overly serious, thank God,
mm-hmm.
but it's a $18,000 procedure.
Ooh, okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
And and they're in litigation with the insurance company. And the attorney said to the doctor, we know that you'll get paid. He said, won't do it, because even if you as an attorney or the patient or even the insurance company who says that they'll take care of it, if the litigation goes south, I'm the one who loses each and every time. And the other thing is, he said, if you want, I have a fee. If I have to work with the insurance company, it's $18,000.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have insurance, it's six.
Wow. That's such a drastic difference. I know what that, yeah.
Yeah.
So what did these people do? Can I ask? Or have they even decided at this point?
No, they haven't decided what to do.
That's interesting. So insurance, like you said, insurance companies, people get big bonuses for as many denials as they can capture, as much money as they can save over the course of a year. So what do you see as the future?
Absolutely.
What do you see as the future since we're winding down? Do you think there's hope here?
You're the intuitive, Survette. You have a better chance of answering that question than I do. I don't know. With the graying of America,
mm-hmm.
with more of us than anybody else, with boomers, turning 65, I think we still have a couple more years of that.
Not many.
I understand.
Yeah, not many.
Yeah, no.
Yeah,
but
our boomers are up there now, you know?
Right. Mm-hmm. And I think that the answer is pretty simple.
Mm-hmm.
Is that we need to start over again. If an insurance company says, I'm going to cover you for health,
mm-hmm.
and I don't understand why they're allowed to back off if after agreeing to pay for something,
mm-hmm.
they're allowed to walk away.
And not
doesn't
pay.
Doesn't make sense to me.
No.
And not pay it.
Right. No, that's never happened. I'm knocking on wood, which is basically my head right now. I'm knocking on my own because really, honestly, they approved the physical therapy while I was in there. But I have already been like three times and they are covering it. But if they just decided at the drop of a hat that they weren't going to, then the answer there is very simple. Then I'm not going because I'm not paying for it. You know, so it's like.
No, you're paying the.
Yeah.
For the insurance.
That's right. So you pay all this money for insurance, which goes up every year, and less is covered. You know, it's crazy.
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah, it's crazy. And the older you are, the harder it is. And or you get into the Medicare realm of things, which is just as difficult, if not more so, correct?
Yeah, absolutely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Not a happy time.
No, but this is why I'm glad there are shows like yours, and this is why you were on the show today, because I wanted to promote this, latenighthealth.com, because really, Mark Alyn has made it his business, here you have, to kind of become a consumer advocate for this and help people fight back, right?
No, absolutely. There's no question.
Yeah. And to find answers. And you have some amazing people. Who's the most interesting person you've interviewed lately?
Oh, that's easy. You.
I was on your show, yeah. Thank you. Okay, besides me, is there anybody?
Robert Clancy, Swami. I interviewed a guy who wrote a book on Alzheimer's disease. He's suffering from it.
Wow, and he wrote a
book out.
He wrote a book about it while he's suffering from it? That's amazing.
Yeah. And it's getting, and it's progressively worse. His name, the name of the book is On Pluto, and there's a second edition out. I've been meaning to bring him back. His name is Greg O'Brien. He's an award-winning reporter, and he travels throughout the country, or was the last time I talked to him about a year ago, speaking about this. But he could no longer travel by himself. He needs somebody because he forgets.
Well, yeah. I mean, I'm surprised he hasn't forgotten he wrote a book. But there you go. You know, that's a real trooper, that he's still out there and he's still doing what he's doing, even if he needs help doing it, which is great, you know? It is.
Right. No, absolutely.
We have to fight
There's
the
no
fight.
Question.
We have to fight the fight, though. We can't just let them do this to us with the high cost of pharmaceuticals and the insurance going through the roof with less and less coverage. It's just, it's gone too far, I think. So whatever we can do to fight back is great. And I love what you're doing and that you have all these great people on the show. And, and you do. You cover both ends. You cover the traditional medicine and the spiritual aspect with people like Swami Tirtha and Robert Clancy. And then, again, the holistic naturopathic medicine. You know, Swami's an expert in Ayurvedic medicine. I mean, all these things that you're touching on that and you do believe in a lot of these things, like chiropractors and acupuncturists and cupping and things like that, correct? Right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
I was at my chiropractor a week ago, and they cut me, 2 weeks ago, and they cut me.
And did it help?
Yeah.
It does?
Yeah, it was an interesting experience.
Have you not
had it? I've never had it done before.
Okay, that was your first time, right?
Right.
And what did you think then? It was interesting? Did you feel some effects from it?
I felt some stress reduction and pain reduction in my back. And I got a kick out of it. I took my shirt off. And my wife looked at me and said, "Oh, my God, what happened to you?"
Yeah, it does
because
look funny.
It does leave a mark.
The marks stay there for a couple of days, too, usually.
Yeah, they do.
They don't go.
They do.
Wow. Okay. I have a text message from a caller in Salt Lake City that says, "Excellent show. Found it very fascinating and informative." There you go. Look at that. No more callers, but we did get some text messages. And what's going to happen is I'm going to get a ton of emails tomorrow or the next day where I had this question, I had that question, and then they think of it later and they don't call, or they're afraid. A lot of people are afraid to call in. So they can find you if they want to reach out to you, Mark. Can they reach out to you on latenighthealth.com? Is there a contact info?
There is a contact. It's info@latenighthealth.com, info@latenighthealth.com. More than happy to answer questions to the best of my ability.
Yeah, perfect. Thank you again, because you're not a doctor, but you are a healthcare consumer advocate, and you've been doing this for a long time, and you've talked to some amazing people. And also, I have to add that you really are a hell of a producer as well, and a videographer. So if anybody, not to mention a television host, and I'm sure there's a game show coming up for you somewhere in the future. I just know it. So we'll be seeing Mark Alyn, not just on the radio or hearing him on the radio, but on TV. I bet money on that one. But it's been delightful to have you. Huh? Well, and I said it on the air live for the whole world to hear. So, yeah, no, this has been fascinating. And I really appreciate it when anyone, especially you, takes time on a Sunday night away from their family to sit down with me for almost an hour and just chat and and give me their time. So I really do appreciate that. And I'm glad that you joined us tonight. I really appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah. And you know what, Mark?
Thank you very much.
Mr. Mark Alyn, please do not stop fighting the fight for us, for these insurance and all these other kickbacks these people are. Anyway, I'm going to get on my soapbox.
I get it.
Before I get on my soapbox. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Servette. Servette is one of the sweetest, nicest people I've ever met.
Thank you.
She is a real person.
Thank you, and so are you. You're the real deal, and I appreciate it. You take care and have a really good evening. Thank you so much for joining me
tonight.
Thank you. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you.
That was a fun show. I mean, very informative, as the Cindy, I think her name was, and somebody in Salt Lake City who texted me. I'm sorry, Cindy. There you are, Cindy, and then there's another caller in Albuquerque. Okay, we mentioned Albuquerque, also saying the same thing. Interesting show. So obviously it's a fascinating subject. And if you need to know more or would like to know more, you can go to latenighthealth.com. And again, that was Mark Alyn, the host of the show that airs on KABC Radio. And if you need to find me, you can find me at servethasan.com, servethasan.com. And all my information is on there about my website. Well, that is my website. My blogs and things are changing. So my website is in under construction. There's still one out there at servethasan.com, but there's a new one being built, and along with a new blog, a new podcast, and a bunch of other things that are going on. This show is now, Clear Source Radio is now an iHeart radio station, so that's new and coming, and I'll be sending out information on that as well. So lots of new stuff coming on, just takes time, and we're all busy, and I'm busy, and it takes time to get things up and running, but you'll be hearing about it in the near future, hopefully by the end of the summer, and my new book, and all those other things that are coming out pretty soon. Anyway, all good. And stay tuned for our show next week. I will not be doing it live because it is Memorial Day weekend and I'll be traveling. But I have an excellent show that I taped ahead of time with a woman who lives in London, England. So it was perfect because she could never do the show live because her schedule doesn't allow it. And it's the crack of dawn, the middle of the night, to be doing a live radio show. Her name is Catherine Jegaday. She's written a book called Infinite Possibility, How to Use the Ideas of Neville Goddard to Create the Life You Want. And if anybody knows me well, they know I'm a huge Neville Goddard fan. He knew about stuff way before other people did. He was talking about metaphysics long ago. And I know even Wayne Dyer, before he passed away, was just giving kudos to Neville Goddard towards the end there. So we will be discussing his philosophy and his practice and how she's kind of put it into a book in a new way. And I've got to wind up here because there's another show that comes on live after me, so I've got to go. But I'm going to say, be you to the full, because I always do, because being your authentic self, which is going to be the whole basis of next week's show, is really truly what gets you what you want in life in the most easiest way, because you go in the flow and things just come. And I will be back live the week after that, June, and I have Lynn Morell on the line that day, and she's fantastic. She's written a wonderful book, and we're going to have a ton of fun. But anyway, be you to the full. I love you all. Stay tuned, and I'll be back in a couple of weeks. Take care. Good night.